A bit of good news for motorists, an oil price rollback expected next week. Gasoline prices may see the biggest drop of as much as 80 centavos, while a liter of kerosene and diesel may be cheaper by 20 to 50 centavos. The Energy Department cites fluctuating demand from superpowers China and the U.S. for the looming price drops.
Sa forecast talaga, mas mataas ang supply kaysa sa demand hanggang second quarter of the year. Which means, mababa ang presyo. But sabi ko nga, on a week, mayroong mga relevant news na nakaka-apekto sa presyuhan at saka sa supply. Yun ang nagpapabago ng direksyon ng presyo. Fluctuating talaga yung demand ng China at saka ng US. Eh, alam naman natin na dalawang malalaking consumer to ng petroleum products.
The Philippines starts the year with a rising unemployment rate. The Statistics Bureau reported Friday the jobless rate was at 4.5% in January, translating to 2.15 million Filipinos out of work. This is up from 3.1% in December last year, but lower than the rate recorded a year ago. Underemployment also continued to rise, coming in nearly 14%. Those who have jobs but still look for extra working hours climbed to over 6.39 million in January. Shortly after the release of the latest jobs data, Manila's top economist NEDA Secretary Arsenio Balisacan vowed the Marcos administration's commitment to attracting more job-generating investments. More local businesses look forward to benefiting from the Tatak Pinoy Act, which seeks to enhance cooperation between the public and private sectors in promoting Philippine-made goods and services. Get to know more about the new measure in this report by Vivian Gulia.
Shoemaker Noel Evangelista just received an order from abroad for 1 million pairs of shoes a year. The problem is, his factory's current capacity is only around 150,000 pairs annually.
Marami naman pong export quality. Ang problema lang, yung ipapag-mass production mo na, hindi namin kayang i-produce.
Programs to help Philippine businesses like Noel's to scale up and improve competitiveness will be front and center in the implementation of the recently signed Tatak Pinoy Act. The law mandates the crafting of a Tatak Pinoy strategy to incrementally expand the product capabilities of domestic enterprises, empower them to produce sophisticated products and services, and help them compete in the global market. It further mandates government financial institutions to ensure the accessibility of credit to domestic enterprises through financing mechanisms like low interest or flexible loan programs. It also states that the government will help facilitate access to domestic and international markets for Philippine products and establish a green lane for the issuance of permits, licenses, certifications, or authorizations to Tatak Pinoy investments. While the Department of Trade and Industry says incubation and innovation centers will be put up to assist in research and development for local products.
Nandito yung mga eksperto para tumulong sa mga negosyante na makapag-innovate. Pati na may mga bagong equipment at mga teknolohiya kagaya ng artificial intelligence, robotics, automation. Matatagpuan mo ito dun sa mga itatayong mga innovation centers. Pwede kang dito makapag-research, gagawin mo yung iyong R&D, yung pananaliksik, gamit itong mga equipment at saka mga bagong teknolohiya para mas maging efficient yung takbo ng iyong negosyo. At kung syempre kung efficient ka, bababa ang iyong cost of business, doing business, at ibig sabihin magiging competitive ka.
When you say made in the Philippines, right now it's associated with things of lesser value. So it is unfortunately, of course, people, there's overseas Filipino workers, of course, Filipino professionals are also respected abroad, particularly in healthcare, our doctors, our nurses, but a lot are also working in low-level services. And if you look at products made in the Philippines, a lot are basic agricultural products, textiles, maybe clothes. So not a lot of value added there. So what we're trying to do with the Tatak Pinoy is at the same time push for made in the Philippines, but also better products made in the Philippines. And the result of that will be better jobs and better industries.
Under the new law, priority for Philippine products and services in sectors covered by the Tatak Pinoy strategy shall be guaranteed in government procurement for a period of 10 years, with a few exceptions. These exceptions are if domestic production is insufficient or unavailable in the required commercial quantities, if the specific or desired quality is not met, or if domestic preference will result in inconsistencies with Philippine obligations under international agreements. Local businessmen welcome the enactment of the measure.
We in the industry are happy na this is an encouragement for the local manufacturer. We are also cognizant of the fact, kailan competitive tayo.
Halos lahat po nung nasasalihan namin, imported po yung, locally lang siya na company, pero imported po yung shoes niya. Mas mura. So kung madadagdagan yung market namin, katulad ng sinasabi dyan sa batas, na yung procurement ng government should be local, maganda po para sa amin.
Kung limitado ang iyong production, mahihirapan kang makalaban dahil mataas nga ang iyong cost of production. Pero kung ang gobyerno, siya na yung unang-unang bibili ng ating mga produkto, isa pang aspeto 'yon na makakapagpalakas. Mapapalaki mo yung iyong market, lalaki ang iyong production at bababa ang iyong cost. So ibig sabihin, magiging competitive ka. Kaya mo nang lumaban sa mga dayuhan. Kahit lowest bid ka, pero may mga karampatang standard, may mga specifications, meron kang kailangang sundin na mga ganong requirements para ikaw ay makapasok.
The council has 8 months to complete the Tatak Pinoy strategy, which will be submitted to the president for approval. Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News.